This is a review of the Craftsman Lighted Tool Series, available from Sears or Ace Hardware or other fine retailers. These tools can be purchased separately or individually in a variety of combinations. I don't have the screwdriver in the set here. I've got the adjustable wrench. This adjusts. There's a metric scale on one side, an inch scale on the other side, and this opens to approximately an inch and a half on the jaw. And on this one here, there's a grip here on the thumb that turns it on and illuminates the light. And there's a separate LED on either side. And the batteries for this light are actually behind this logo here, removable by a hex key on the side. The grip is about 9 inches long in length. I found this to perhaps be one of the most useful out of all the lighted series ones. I've used this working under the sink, fixing water lines, replacing sinks. And the lights on here is really useful in the right situations. I don't always need it, but when it's there, it's there. And I've had this for about a year since it came out, year and a half since it first came out. I haven't had to replace the batteries yet. We'll put that aside. Then we also have the linesman pliers. These have the nice square nose at the top as the knurled ends here. You can see the just a little bit of debris in there from the use. I've had these also for about a year, year and a half. And there's the batteries on all these pliers where the batteries are contained inside the pivot point on the pliers. This has a nice loose fit here that I like. The pliers line up. You can see the light through them just a little bit there. And then the light on this one, and the pliers is right there on the middle of the jaw when it opens, hopefully illuminating your work area. I've not particularly found the need where I've had to use the light specifically on these. I have used them occasionally just to light something odd place up and stand it up or prop it up to get access to the light. This is an odd source of light. They're very comfortable to use. They've got a nice long grip. They fit nicely in my hands. If you want to replace the battery, you remove these keys here, these screws, pop the batteries out. One of the complaints that I've read about these is the batteries are not cheap if you have to replace them. This uses a couple. When you first get it, there's a demo mode or a trial mode so that in the store the batteries don't die on these. So you have to hold the switch down for a while and follow the instructions to make sure you get it off demo mode and into regular use mode. So you can turn it on, turn it off. And then the next one is the long nose pliers. Unfortunately, my experience with these long nose pliers has been very less than satisfactory. They're extremely stiff to use. Maybe they need to drop oil, or I need to take some time to break them in better or work it apart, because these are just require quite a bit of force to use that I don't usually. I've put these down and use it in favor of other pliers simply because of how stiff the grips are. And I can say the same thing also about the side cutters. Although these are a little bit less loose or a little bit less tight, all these pliers types still have the LED in the middle and are configured exactly the same. If we stack these up end to end, you can see the linesman pliers and the side cutting pliers. The side are just a little bit shorter, and the long nose pliers are just a little bit taller. If you put the wrench right in front here, then all these together fit and are about 9 inches long or so. And they work great. They're a great addition to anyone's tool set. They may not be the best value for what they are, especially if you consider life cycle costs of a battery. In the right situation, you might find these valuable. My only complaint is I wish they also made just a pair of just regular slip joint pliers that was illuminated just to complete the series. For some reason, they don't. The only tool they make to complete the series that's not here is the screwdriver with changeable bits. I have elected not to buy that. That just doesn't seem to make any sense for my tool selection. I also might add, on the long nose pliers, there's an extra little grip, knurled surface here. I had to be able to grab something else to be able to pull there. Of course, you've got the side cutters here in the middle and the end. The angled pliers also have the grip here on the inside, as well as on the linesman pliers to be able to pull. There is no integrated cable puller, as some linesman pliers have. But these linesman pliers have been actually great linesman pliers for what they are. They rest the and the adjustable wrench has been great. The other ones, your mileage may vary if you get a better pair in store that have grips that are The tightness is more to your liking. Perhaps you like them tighter. I like mine a little bit looser so I can work them easily with one hand. I find myself struggling with one hand. I sometimes be able to pop these open if my other hand is busy. That it's just holding it open. It won't pop open for me. I've got to force my finger in there to get it open. Of course, it'll hold closed, but with enough the right thing, it will pop right off. One other concern, though, on the adjustable wrench, the grip here does feel rather plasticky. There's been a couple times I've been worried that I was going to crack the grip. So far, it hasn't happened. If it were to happen, it is covered by the Craftsman warranty. Of course, there's a nice little hook here at the end. We'll attach it to a belt or to put it on just a tool hook on your belt. And so this is a look at the Craftsman Illuminated Lighted Tool Series. If these are right for you, go ahead and purchase them, and maybe it's a possible Father's Day gift. Thanks, and have a great day.